So Komal's on her way right now. She has just messaged me. And what I'm gonna do now is like I'm gonna just act like, oh, we're not shooting or anything, and I'm just gonna piss her off. And I'm just gonna wait for her to explode. Cause I think I want to do this. I think it'd be really interesting. So let's see how she reacts. She's here.
What have you gotten?
Listen, do you even want to shoot today though? Are you feeling like
Siddharth,
shooting?
Siddharth, don't do this. I've come here with my makeup on, yeah. Especially, I wouldn't have put makeup today. Don't do this. Let's do it
I
today.
I don't feel like shooting at all.
Now, when you want to shoot this, you are going to come over to my place and shoot it.
You're so rude
come
to
on,
me, Komal.
Don't do this. But if you're not in the mood, then let's not. But yeah, the next time, like, you are coming to my place to shoot. That's all.
I just wanted to prank you.
Right.
And you have really exploded. Hi guys, welcome to my channel Dar Kyun Gaye.
I did not even sit, mujhe ready bhi nahi hone diya.
So that was the point. Well, this is basically the video where we answer all the questions that you guys asked about our relationship on my Instagram.
And there are quite many.
So guys, maine iske phone pe bhej diye hain sab. She's going to be the moderator for this video.
This is going to be the phone. Don't mind my cover. This cover Siddharth had gifted me aur maine iski ye halat kar di hai.
तो गिफ्ट की बात नहीं थी, मैं बोल रहा था कि ये एक महीने में इसने इसकी हालत की थी और मैंने इसको बोला था कि डू यू वांट दिस कलर बिकॉज ये काफी जल्दी गंदा होगा.
सो दिस इज नॉट द कलर दैट आई वांटेड टू गो फॉर, लाइक इट हैज बिकम लाइक दिस बिकॉज आई एम जस्ट अ क्लमजी गर्ल. सो ओके, दिस इज नो वन आस्क बट आई थिंक वी कैन स्टार्ट ऑफ
एग्जैक्टली नो वन
दैट. सो आई एम लाइक एक्सट्रीमली क्लमजी एंड ही इज लाइक प्रॉपर. You would never see him dropping anything on his shirt while eating. And I might come across as someone who's like so proper, but yeah. Reality कुछ और है.
इसने मेरा पजामा सूट लिया था, घर पे पहन के गई थी और मैं इससे FaceTime कर रहा था एक दिन. मैंने कहा ये सामने इतनी पीले स्टेज की क्या लग रही है? ये दाल किसको खिला रही है ब्रो?
इतना भी नहीं है. अच्छा ठीक है चलो. ओ एनीवे, लेट्स नॉट बोर यू गाइस.
आई थिंक वी विल बिगिन द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
ओके यू रीड.
हाउ डू यू गाइस मीट? हु मेड द फर्स्ट मूव? Okay, so how did we meet?
Okay, should I go
of
first?
Of course,
okay.
Why don't you?
So we actually met, I think, 3-4 years ago?
3 to 4 years ago.
3 to 4 years ago.
When I moved to Delhi.
Moved
yeah.
to Delhi from Bombay.
Bombay.
He was working in Bombay.
I think we met in the very first 2 weeks of
you moving to Delhi.
Moving, yeah.
Yeah. And so we met at Summer House. So Summer House is this very, I don't know if it's still happening, but it used to be really
yeah.
like this
popular.
Happening popular place yeah. 3 years ago. And
all
me,
the PopExo girls used to love dancing.
I used to work at PopExo and it was yeah. a ritual for us to kind of, not just us like people who used to work with me, but for me and Dolly also.
Guys, you look, I think every Thursday you guys used to go for a ladies night.
Oh, Thursday or the ladies night?
Thursday. Yeah. So basically we went. I was in office and I think Dolly's the first friend I made and she was like, you want to go out drinking? And I had just moved in. I was like, of course. So she took me, went to a house first, which was also pretty close to Summer House actually,
yeah.
if I'm not wrong. And we also walked to Summer House, I remember this very distinctly. And she said, my friend bhi wahan pe aa rahi hai and it's a ladies night or something. So it'll be like super fun. I'm like, done. So
I think we were 3 to 4 girls yeah. together, I think.
So then hum gaye the and then I'll tell you like how did you guys meet, who made the first move. First of all, the first move didn't happen. It happened years later.
Yeah. Because at that point of time, I was already in a yeah. serious relationship.
Yeah.
And you were also kind of not looking for a relationship.
I wasn't actively looking for anything. Yeah. I had just moved in and I was like getting used to the city, to be honest. But yeah, so then I'll tell you how I saw her.
Okay.
I'll tell you how I saw her.
Okay, can I say first?
Done,
okay. What I thought when I saw him. Yeah, so like Dolly and I, it used to be our ritual that we would go to Summer House once a week dancing. And so this one fine evening, I see this guy also with her.
Did you think I was dating her? No, she was dating someone that time.
She was already dating someone at that point of time. I just saw him. So the first thought that came to my mind was, of course, that, oh, he's cute, of course, because he is quite conventionally attractive, if I might say. So I found him attractive. I thought to myself that, oh, that's a cute guy. And that's it.
So I remember in Bhar ka area hota tha, Summer House pe, and I was standing at the edge. And there were too many people that day. And me and Dolly were just talking. So I was standing here and Dolly was talking to me here. So I could basically see Summer House completely. And I was seeing like a bunch of people. And I had just come in. So I was checking out, you know, har jagah nayi city mein, you want to check out the crowd, you want to check out like the bar. And I see this girl with the pink highlights, red highlights.
Red
or something.
Highlights.
I legit noticed her.
Who would not notice a girl with like red hair?
No, more than that, I think to me it was these gigantic bohemian earrings that she was wearing.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, that's massive, but that's interesting. And then I was standing and then I looked at her and I was looking at her. And obviously, I mean, it was just like a thing where you're just looking at a girl and you're like, okay, she's really cute and she's really pretty. And I found her extremely beautiful, I remember. But I didn't tell Dolly. And then all of a sudden, this woman taps Dolly's shoulder and she's like, hi. And then they meet and then I meet. And then Dolly, by the way, told me after that this was the friend who was meeting us. Like, she's like my best friend. I'm like, oh. But then eventually I remember we started talking. Ek bus stop tha wahan pe niche. I think I was waiting for a cab or you were waiting. I honestly did know of her, but I didn't really know of her.
Really? You
I remember
knew
you.
Of me?
I knew of you. Like when I looked at you, I was like, yeah, I think I've seen her, but I wasn't sure. I remember she showed me her profile. I think who was with us?
So full of myself. I cannot believe that I actually met someone for the first time and I showed them my profile. Here, see now, see my Instagram. I can't believe I did this with you.
And
this is so embarrassing.
I was like, okay, now I know why she's looking the way she's looking because that's her style. And then we started following each other, I remember. At that time, our handle was the College Couture.
And you were so hard, 93 Batram.
I was the same. But I think what's more important is that when I went back home, I have spoken about this in an interview also, that I called my best friend from Pune, Yashasri, and I told her that I met this girl and she's the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. Yeah, and just take the compliment. And Yashasri was like, who's this girl? Who's this girl? Who's this girl? And then I showed her the profile. And she was like, yeah, she's really pretty.
I had no clue that he was noticing me. So you're so like sly about your moves.
Yeah.
That it kind of feels like he's not interested. Haan. You know.
Yahan pe guys, snake dal do because that's what she's called me. So that's how we met.
That was one hell of a long answer.
Does being in the same profession add to fun or do you time box conversations? How do you guys make time for each other in your busy schedules? How do you guys find time for personal and for each other without overstepping boundaries? Has being in the same industry given you any challenges? Basically, a bunch of questions.
About how...
Yeah, like how do we deal with our professional life being so intertwined with our personal life? I think it comes pretty organic, I would say. I think what's important is that both of us have our own lives. Professionally also. And personally.
And I think it's a good balance. Of course, we have our days when it kind of does get overwhelming.
There were times, obviously. And there are continue to be times where we don't speak almost through the day because we're both shooting, or if she's not shooting, I'm shooting, and if she's shooting, I'm not shooting, or anything. Like, we just don't end up speaking.
The best part about it is that there's so much empathy because your partner literally knows what you're going through. There's no space, like, we're literally each other's mirror. Yeah. The other person understands. There's no scope of.
Koi scope hi nahi hai, guys. Scope hi nahi hai.
It's too transparent because he literally does the same thing as I do. And
I think I personally love the fact that we both sort of understand what the problems may be and also not in a lot of places. Because you've been around for like way too long and like I have just started off. So it actually works for both of us because I now understand.
There's so much to learn. That's such a great point, which means there's so much to learn because he's kind of started off right now. It's been a year, I think. And I've been doing this for 6 years.
Yeah.
There's so much he can give me and there's so much I can give him, which kind of creates the perfect kind of balance because he's so relatively new at this.
I think both of us, I mean, I'm just going to be super blunt about it. I think when you come in super fresh in the industry, you sort of come with like slightly newer perspectives, and then you've been around for too long, you've sort of become a machine. You're constantly producing content, so I feel I bring something to her and she brings something.
I think we've been together for a year.
I can see
this for myself, that since the time I started going out with him, I have become more comfortable with kind of like trying out new things work-wise. Mm. Otherwise, I'm quite uptight with my approach to anything, to relationships, to friendships, work, anything. So I think he's helped me kind of break out of my shell. I still seek for comfort more than change.
Yeah.
Unlike
that's
you,
true.
You seek for change more than
I'm
comfort.
A Libran, na? I'm
yeah.
a Libran. Guys, Librans ko hamesha nayi cheeza chahiye, okay?
So we kind of balance each other out.
Yeah. But we've also discussed this in the past, that do we sort of have days planned in a week? That every week, like, we have to do something or we have to meet and, like, we have to spend the time through the day and we don't sit on our phones or anything like that. But then I think that never really worked because it doesn't work.
Personally, we just like to be organic and go with the flow.
So beautiful, yeah. पैर सो गया posting stories or she's posting stories or I'm vlogging or anything.
I think we're very out there on social media and I think you guys would also agree.
We're very... If someone has fallen on the sofa, if someone has
fallen on the sofa, a lot of people also find it very cringe and you know what? We empathize. When we see someone else, we also sometimes like, oh God, like cut it out. Like this but is too much PDA. But then I think we figured out that we're also the same kind of people and we're okay with it. It's fine.
I think the question, Komal, actually was that how do you decide what about your relationship?
No, Bobo, that is what I'm saying, na.
I think if I were you guys and you were watching us, I'll be like, bro, yaar, ye kya kar rahe hai yaar? Puri time.
Believe me, we
were romantic. Puri time. Itne kya hai yaar? Aise pyar thodi na hota yaar.
But let me tell you, you guys only see probably 5% of what really happens.
Anything that you see has so much more perspective in real life. There's so much more to what you see that you only see a little bit of it. And I think that's the answer to this question. That there is a very subconscious restraint that we have towards what we show and what we don't. Because with some things, I think subconsciously you want to hold them very sacred. And yaar, mera pair actually so gaya.
Oh, just change your position. Okay, 5 things you like and dislike about each other. I would say what I like about him. First one is his how expressive he is. He has a way with words, so there's nothing that he cannot express, good things, bad things. Number two would be he is extremely, extremely, extremely caring and nurturing. He would just take care of you.
Aww.
So that's number two for me. Number three for me would be, what else do I love about you?
Nothing else she loves.
No, of course I do.
She's like, kapde acche pehen leta hai, baal bhi acche kar leta hai.
Shut up. Can I just list my dislikes? Because right now I'm disliking
him. I think that would be easier. Abhi asliyat bahar aa rahi hai na, dislikes hi hain bas. 30 minutes later.
Is his ability to kind of break bad habits and develop good habits.
तो मुझे नहीं पता था अपने बारे में.
This is a great thing.
यार ये कितना टाइम ले रही है यार, ये क्या बोर कर रही है यार.
You're so annoying. Okay, now I'll move on to dislikes. First thing that I dislike about him is the fact is his jokes. Okay, it's so fucking annoying. Like boils my blood. Number two, the fact that he is that person who will keep fucking like testing your patience because he likes to annoy you, so he will keep saying things and doing things to fucking like make you scream, and that's just his nature.
What do I like and dislike about her? I'm just trying to think now. I think what I really like about her is the fact that no matter where she goes or no matter who she meets, which I think says a lot about her emotional health and it says a lot about her heart and how she approaches relationships, she really makes you feel comfortable. She feels like home. She feels like the person, like if she meets you tomorrow, you would feel like you're wanted. You will feel like you're loved. And I think that reassurance that she offers to humans, I think is very special to have. I think that emotional reassurance that she offers to people, I think that's really, really special. And I think offering that to anyone is very special, to be honest, not just to me. Number two, she's also a keeper. She's a very, very, very strong keeper of relationships, of things. As she mentioned, you know, she lets go of things super easily, but she's technically a keeper. It's very hard for her to let go also.
No, because I either love or hate. Yeah. So I love so much that
passionately.
I will... Yeah, it's passionate always,
I think the third thing is definitely that she's someone who constantly enables you. I think the word has to be enabled. She can really enable you to do things that you had not thought of doing. So I think that's something that I've also learned from her, that a lot of things are less about whether you're capable of doing it and they're more about how much you're unable to do them by yourself or by people around you. What I dislike about her, I think her passion for things tends to take over her a lot of time, which gets her very, 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 very stressed. I want her to sort of ease out a little bit.
Basically, yeah, just ease out.
With being so passionate towards things that when things go wrong, it just really affects her. So that's something I dislike about her. On what topics do you guys fight or start arguing with each other? How do you sort out things? How do you deal with disagreements or difference of opinion? Guys, we fight a lot.
We fight a lot.
We fight a lot.
What really saves the relationship is the fact that we're both such communicators. He's more of a communicator than me. We believe in talking and talking and talking. Like none none of us are escapists. We wouldn't run away from having conversations discussing our differences. We're always open to talk.
I think we've also become more open to talking. I think the communication bit, I would say, we started communicating more and more after we had this like one real talk in Goa when we were there for New Year's. To me, I think that was a defining conversation that we had. Like, we really spoke it all out. I think for the longest time, both of us sort of were, what is the word? We were feeling a little claustrophobic with what we really were feeling in certain situations, and we weren't really letting it out.
Of course, we've had like many bad like every relationship, you know, and where we've also like kind of reevaluated if it's even worth it.
Yeah.
But it is what it is. We have always fought for each other because we've believed in communication. Also, especially for me, because I have been in my previous relationships, they were all long term. There was literally zero communication. So for me, I cherish this relationship so much because there's so much communication between the both of us. There's so much communication between the both of
us. So who should apologize here? Please tell me.
You, for annoying me.
I should apologize. Yeah. Absolutely. How we solve fights is by communicating and letting the other know that you need to shut up, bro.
Okay, cool. Who's more understanding and loving?
Who apologizes first when you fight?
I apologize first. Who's more understanding and loving? Who do you think?
I think both of us are understanding and loving, I would say.
Yeah, like, I don't think we can mesh.
And I don't think, like, that. I think, you know, the apology, basically, she's always at fault. I'm kidding. No. She's never at fault. She's the perfect girlfriend, right? Like, I'm the perfect boyfriend. इसको एक्चुअली ना पूरे टाइम अटेंशन चाहिए, इसको मैसेजेस चाहिए, कॉल चाहिए. तो मतलब अगर अभी लड़ ली है और हम बात नहीं कर रहे हैं तो ऑब्वियसली अब अटेंशन तो नहीं मिलेगी. तो जल्दी से चलो मैसेज करो, टेक्स्ट करो, आई एम सो सॉरी. बेसिकली दैट्स द थिंग फॉर हर. इफ यू डोंट गिव हर अटेंशन, शी विल डू एनीथिंग. सो शी विल टेक एक्यूलेड्स ऑफ एनी फॉर्म इन अ रिलेशनशिप टू बेसिकली गेन अटेंशन. सो वो सॉरी नहीं बोल रही है आपको, बेसिकली बोल रही है कि लिसन टॉक टू मी ना. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज मोर सेक्रेट इन योर रिलेशनशिप, इमोशनल और फिजिकल प्रॉक्सिमिटी? ये तो रिलेशनशिप का कोई कौन बनेगा करोड़पति बन रहा है.
फॉर मी आई थिंक ऑफ कोर्स बोथ आर इंपॉर्टेंट, बट फॉर मी आई वुड से इट्स इमोशनल प्रॉक्सिमिटी दैट्स मोर इंपॉर्टेंट इन द लॉन्ग रन.
आई थिंक इट्स बोथ फॉर मी. आई थिंक इमोशनल एंड फिजिकल प्रॉक्सिमिटी इज इंटर रिलेटेड, आई वुड से. ऑफ कोर्स द डायनामिक्स ऑफ बोथ वर्क डिफरेंटली, एंड आई थिंक एज टाइम प्रोग्रेसेस इन अ रिलेशनशिप एंड एज अ रिलेशनशिप प्रोग्रेस, लाइक बोथ हैव देयर ओन ट्रैजेक्टरीज एंड पाथ्स. इमोशनल बॉन्डिंग चेंजेस a certain way and physical proximity changes a certain way, but I'm also okay if I'm having to compromise on either at some point to keep the bond stronger. Hypothetically, if I'm saying at some point years down the line, I mean, we've seen our parents, emotional proximity remains, but I think the physical proximity
kind of fades out.
So I feel if you moving out and talking to more people, meeting more people, and just taking a break from each other after 40 years, 50 years of a relationship, I think it's okay till the time the aim is to keep the bond strong.
Whatever works for your relationship. Every relationship has different priorities.
Yeah.
Maybe like at this point, for both of us, emotional proximity is more important or physical proximity is more important. Maybe 10 years down the line, we're different people and we seek for emotional proximity. So I think it's really subjective and it really depends on where you're at personally as well.
Yeah.
Something you have learned from each other that made you a better person. Fun fact about me is that I either love a person or hate a person.
Mere se zyada Libra to ye hai.
And this I'm only talking about people who I know. So people in my life, and I have very few friends, so I would either love them and I would take a bullet for them, or I would just like kind of just delete you out of my life. And I have always lived in the extremes. What I have learned from Siddharth is that that's a very unhealthy way of being. And if something or some relationship is not working out for you, it's not important for you to throw that away completely and kind of, you know, just uproot it from your life.
And like throw it off.
Yeah, sometimes you just make peace with it.
You have to be okay with
that. Okay, now this is what it has come down to, and draw your boundaries. So what he has taught me is to draw boundaries and not completely kind of just be like boy bye.
I think what I've learned from her is to stop making excuses for things, because excuses are basically just a way to allow yourself to procrastinate and allow yourself to slack and allow yourself to not do things that you technically should be doing. I think she's taught me not to make excuses and keep going, which is the reason why I have these tattoos now. She's affected my life so much that she's given me a lesson that I've gotten tattooed on me for life. So that's what it is.
What is the strongest thing in your relationship that keeps your bond strong?
For I have a very simple answer to this, but you can go first.
For me, like I said, it's communication. We talk a lot about anything and everything we're feeling. We communicate. That's the best thing.
I think to me, it's the fact that I want it. I want it enough. Definitely. It's about like how much do I want it. So yeah. To me, the strongest thing is that I just want it. You know?
That we both want each other.
Yeah. I just want it to work.
We really, from the bottom of our hearts, want this to work. There's maximum effort.
Who's more romantic? Had to ask this question.
I have the perfect answer for this. I am more romantic, but he's more cheesy.
She's absolutely right. I am definitely more cheesy. She's definitely more romantic. Yeah, yeah.
I'm a romantic, but he's definitely like
super cheesy. I agree.
You know, yeah. It's almost like. Like stop
it. Do I deserve you?
Almost like sometimes like stop, I don't even deserve you. Or sometimes like stop, that's just so cringe. Stop, you know, stop saying or doing those things. But it's just the person that he is.
Yeah. Next question. Favorite memory together? Okay. I know a memory. Yeah.
I don't know. I don't have a set memory like that. Yeah. But for me, when we had just initially started dating, yeah. We used to go out a lot. Okay, so yeah. We would go for coffee and dinners. And I know it sounds very superficial, but right after that, COVID happened, lockdown happened, and we couldn't see each other for a very long time. So I think in that lockdown, we got so much closer.
Mm.
You know, we got to know each other and we would FaceTime each other all day. We would talk so much. We were both so vulnerable at that point of time. All of us, in fact, because the country was going through
the entire world was going through an emotional whirlpool.
Yeah, and we didn't know what to do. I think at that point of time, our relationship grew much more stronger. Two things could have happened. Either we would have completely fallen apart. Or we would have grown stronger. And I'm just so glad that we grew stronger. Just became more and more fond of each other. So I think that entire period, I was kind of formed the base of our relationship. Cute. What's for you?
Oh, my favorite memory. I have, of course, like told her about it. Yeah. I think for me, my favorite memory.
Oh, I know.
What?
When you met me.
Yeah. So post the lockdown, you know, when we were getting closer and closer and closer and closer. And then I finally met her after the first lockdown, I think.
I think after 3 months.
No, it was more than that. Like it was quite a few months actually. And then I finally met her in person, like physically. And I remember I had goosebumps. When I looked at her, when I hugged her, I had goosebumps and I just wouldn't let go of her. I just wanted to hold her super tight and just wanted to hold her super close and I just didn't want to let her go. And I think that's also the time when I realized that how much she means to me and how much this means to me and how much I want this every single day.
Yeah.
So I think that moment when I hugged her, when I met her and I remember her face when I looked at her. It was something else, I would say. Like I literally had goosebumps. Like I was super happy and more than that, it just affected me emotionally in such a positive manner that it left a huge memory in my mind that I wish I could
relive
that feeling that I had. And that's it for all the questions.
We're done. This was probably the first time we have
spoken about
our relationship.
Intricate details about our relationship.
The first time we've sat down together and
done a very candid,
such an insightful video about our relationship.
Yeah, that's true. But I think it was pretty interesting. I think 2-3 cheeze hai to mereko actually nahi pata tha that she said. I think it's really nice. Ab main uske liye lunch order karunga because I feel like she deserves a lot of things in life. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope aap logo ko answers mil gaye hain and aapko पूरा समझ आ गया है कि गाइस ये रिलेशनशिप जैसी रिलेशनशिप्स होती है वैसी ही है और इसमें कुछ अलग नहीं है. आई थिंक आई होप दिस वाज लाइक सुपर इनसाइटफुल. आई थिंक यू गाइस वुड हैव सॉर्ट ऑफ रिलेटेड टू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स आल्सो बिकॉज इट इज व्हाट मोस्ट रिलेशनशिप्स आर. सो इसके बाद हम ब्रेकअप अप कर ही लेंगे और उसके बाद फिर पैचअप भी कर लेंगे. पर यही होता है गाइस.
दिस इज व्हाट आई मीन बाय हिज अननोइंग
जोक. कितना मारती है यार.
टेल हिम इन द कमेंट सेक्शन दैट ही इज नॉट funny.
So I think this is my cue to end the video.
Okay.
All you need to do now,
subscribe to his channel. Guys, let us know in the comment section below the other kind of videos you'd like us to do together.
Absolutely.
And don't forget to like this video, share this video, hit the bell icon, and yeah, subscribe to his channel. Look at his face. Why wouldn't you want to subscribe to his channel?
Look at his face. Mar rahi hai yaar.
Look, show your face. Subscribe. I'm out. Bye.
She has just said ho gaya mera.